हेलो, अ वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ईच एंड एवरीवन हु हैज कम. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ईच एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट ऑफ द 2021 ऑफ द 2020-24 बैच. वेलकम टू डीएससी केजीसी डेवलपर्स. तो डेवलपर्स स्टूडेंट्स क्लब केजीसी इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म वेर यू कैन ग्रो. द बेस्ट वे टू टेल यू अबाउट डीएससी इज दैट इट्स अ ह्यूज वेयर हाउस और अ ह्यूज स्टोर हाउस ऑफ टैलेंट. देर आर इनक्रेडिबली अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ टैलेंटेड पीपल इन इन आर ग्रुप. वी प्रोमोट डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ऑल काइंड. ओके, एंड एंड नॉट ओनली आर वी अ क्लब, वी आर अ कम्युनिटी. सो द डिफरेंस इज दैट वी नॉट ओनली हार्नेस आर ओन स्किल्स बट वी ऑल्सो हेल्प अदर्स ग्रो अलॉन्ग विद अस. ओके, सो डी एस सी इज अ वेरी गुड प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वन ऑफ यू टू लर्न. ओके, सो I would like to welcome our guest speaker, Pravas Jhada. I would like to tell the 2021 batch that you guys are indeed extremely lucky. You are in presence of greatness. Pravas Jhada is indeed one of the best coders or the best developer that KGEC has ever seen. Dada has a stellar profile, which includes many impressive internships, namely Geeks for Geeks, Quikr. I hope all of you are familiar with these names. He's got several amazing projects to his CV. And other than that, he's also the current president of the coding club of KGEC, Keygen Coders. Okay. And I hope each and every one of you have a very fruitful and a very informative session. Trust me, you won't be disappointed after this. Okay. I would like to hand on the mic to our guest speaker, Pravas Jhada. On to you. Okay.
Hey, hello everyone. Welcome. Thanks DSC for organizing this event, and thank you everyone for joining me. So let's start. So let me share my screen. Okay, so why I have suggested the topic as grabbing off campus opportunities and not cracking off campus opportunities, because first of all, there are many first year students, and the second and third year students already know how are the campus placements in our college. So, and the first year students will and might also be knowing, like they are in, like have joined the college, so they also be knowing that we don't have much product based companies coming in our campus and all, but we have seen many seniors who have cracked off campus like jobs at Google, Microsoft, Amazon, D-Shaw, and in our batch also many off campus internships and all people have cracked it. So actually the problem here is that we don't have much guidance on how we can crack the interviews and all, like the right from applying to preparation. We don't have much guidance. The only thing that we have in our college is the good coding environment, and all the seniors and my batchmates and even juniors all are into coding and all, but somewhere they are lacking. Like I have seen many good coders in my batch, even there are people better than me in competitive coding who are not able to crack or get opportunity to interviewing at different big companies. So I have faced many challenges in this off campus like hunting and all. So I would like to share not only my experience with companies, but in general an overview of all kinds of companies like Google, Microsoft, or other big like product based companies, which even or startups which even pay more than Amazon, Microsoft, and those kinds of companies. So many people don't know much about the companies and where to apply and how to apply, and the most important thing is preparation. So you might be doing coding and all the years, but in interviews you might get stuck at many different kinds of things which are also required apart from coding. So I thought like it will be beneficial for you to know all these things beforehand, so that while applying and preparing you don't miss out the important things. Okay, and while I'm sharing this and showing you, like telling my experience, if I ask something, like if you are getting or not, you can reply on the chat. And if you have any questions, you can also type in the chat. I will take the important questions. But I think the things that I covered will mostly answer all your questions automatically, hopefully. So let's start. So about me, so final year CSE undergraduate. Did like 6-7 internships. Currently I'm an internet browser stack, which is a very big startup. And like, apart from the work, the pay is also very good. If you can search about the company, like in Google, you will get an idea about it. What does the company do and what kind of people are there? Okay, so other than that, like I've interned in Quikr, IIT Delhi, Bright Money, Coding Ninjas, Geeks4Geeks, ExitMock, and other startup. So I've also been to ACM, ICPC regionally. So, okay, you might not heard of it. So we will give you an idea in Keejan Coders about the competitive coding and what are the different coding competitions and all, which are famous and all. So that can help you in like improving your CV and all. Okay. So this is a little bit about me. Okay, so let's begin. Like, where to start? Like, what you can people do? I know most of you here are from first year, and like giving an interviews and are mostly people do from third year and all. But like mostly are here from first year. So if you get an idea beforehand, then you can plan accordingly, like how to begin and how to prepare. So that's fine. So let me give you an idea. So let's start from right from your preparation. I mean, right from your profile, like what you are. Let's start from here. So like resume and LinkedIn profile, like while you applying, what happens in on campus is that when a company come, it allows everyone to give the initial like online test and all. Okay, but what happens in off campus, you are being shortlisted after your resume is viewed, or like that also depends on many other factors like your college name and other things also. So, but resume and LinkedIn profile is the most important thing where the recruiters or the employees can notice you. So the first important thing of a resume is that your resume should be of one page always. Okay. And what are the things that you have to, why one page? Because most people don't have much time to see your resume because they have to go through like hundreds and thousands of resumes. Okay. So you have to prepare a resume in one page with all the important things that are necessary, like apart from education and all. So, and the most important things is what you can showcase to the recruiter, that what you have, like achievements and internships are what make you like apart from the, like in, stand out from the other candidates. Okay. So like people who are currently in first year, they can start doing competitive coding, like just to gain, like you start participating coding contests or hackathons. Like I know many people are very beginner in coding, but if at least start learning coding if you want a technical career and or something like that. Start like doing competitive coding on Code Forces, Code Chef, and take part in those contests. Also in many college fests, and take mostly in like state level or national level contests are there, like Google Code Jam, Facebook Hacker Cup, those kinds of things. So if you get good rank in those, that are very much like good for your resume. Okay. And like hackathons also, like if you are into development and all, then you can try like Smart India Hackathon and many other different companies which conduct their own hackathons, and the ranks in those hackathons shows that you are a good developer and your resume are more likely to get shortlisted. And apart from that, in first year, don't try to get internships. Okay, try to develop your skills first, because I've seen many like people from past, many people have paying me to ask like where I can apply internships, and because but they don't have much experience in coding or development. So first year, just try to gain experience and get your hands on development and all. So that can help you in getting an internship at the end of third year. That will be very, at the end of second year, if you can get an internship, that will be very good. But by the end of third year, at least try to get an internship, or if you can get in a big company, that would be very good. Okay, so that's how the experiences and internships matter, because that make you stand out of the crowd. Okay, because many people don't have much internships and experiences. Now the important thing is like the LinkedIn. You know, the most I can say is, so what happens in like if you can see my connections, like I have over 3,000 connections, okay? So what happens like in LinkedIn, start building connections that you, I've most of the internships that I got are from LinkedIn only. Like LinkedIn helped me to get that, but from browser side, it was an off-campus like drive. So, but most of the other internships I got because of LinkedIn. It is a very important like thing to get job opportunities and all. So first of all, try to get connect with the employees. Like how will you connect? Like go to a particular company, search here, any company, Amazon or something. Find the people and just ping, like send connection requests to people, and just keep following people. Okay. Then what happens like when you are in second year, third year, when the companies recruit now, the employees like post like there are openings in their company, or they ask like there is one opening, you ping me, I will refer you, or you get to know about the opportunities. So that's the most important thing. And the more you connections you have, the more chances of seeing the opportunities which your other people can't see. Like the more number of companies you follow, more people you follow, more opportunity you will see. That's the thing. And so now the that's how, and like the and why people will refer you, that is one important thing. Like there are thousands of students applying off campus, but not everyone gets referrals and all, because their profile are not good. Like if you ask someone like, can you refer me, why will they refer? What do you have apart from, like from being in like tier three college and all? So you have to make your like LinkedIn account very impressive. Add achievements, add projects, internships, whatever you have done, just add it. That will make your profile strong. And I'm not saying that you just begin like in first year, obviously you won't have much achievements, but in second or third year you should have few projects or at least few achievements, if not internships. Okay, so that makes you stand out, and then people will give you referrals. So that's how LinkedIn is important. And the most other important thing about LinkedIn is that you can see the job section here. So you can just search for any job. You can you can make some companies, like those are your dream companies or that. So you can make notifications for that company, like whenever they post some opportunities and all, then you can get notifications. And so that's how this job section works. This is very helpful. Like you can get many opportunities from here only, because most companies, apart from posting on their career page, they also post the openings in their LinkedIn jobs page. So this is the thing. And so the LinkedIn and resume is the first step to find your off-campus opportunity or in any companies, be it Microsoft, Amazon, or any companies, like even startups like OYO, Razorpay, any kinds of companies. Most, and obviously you will want to go to big, like good companies and all, not just few service-based or small companies. And obviously you should target big. So that's the thing. And for making resumes, you can use like you can make your own resume from Internshala and all, but I believe like if you have some good, like these two websites are pretty good, novoresume.com and flowcv.io. These are like ready-made, they can give you ready-made templates, so you don't have to much about the designing and adjusting the things. So this is one good thing to make resume. Now let me tell you more about my experiences, my friends' experience, and my seniors' experiences of applying, getting shortlisted, and all these things. So this is the most toughest, I believe, like after interview, getting shortlisted is the toughest thing, or maybe getting shortlisted is more difficult than the interview itself. Okay. Because one of the major reason is that we are from a unknown college, but we are really like people know because of our coding culture and all. But usually in front of companies, we don't have much like presence. So that makes us a little hard for us to get noticed. Okay, but that's the truth. It's nothing to be demotivated, but that's the truth. Okay. So first of all, like I said, how you can find opportunities. Like go to career pages of companies, like make connections on LinkedIn. And also there are many LinkedIn pages, like many people, like I also came to know about this in my third year and all. Like there are many pages like intern, paid interning, or many different pages that can give you that those post about the opportunities, like post about all kinds of opportunities. Okay, so you can easily get the notifications and all from this kind of pages. That's a very good thing, like very useful thing. Many people don't know, like even in my batch, many people don't use these kinds of things, but it is very helpful in getting to know that, yeah, there are openings in company, because I have seen like my batchmates who are very good at coding, okay, but they couldn't apply. First of all, like some links get expired in one day, okay. And after one day, they come to know that there was an opening in this company, and they don't apply. They couldn't apply. That's the thing. So that's a very regretful thing. Okay. Okay. So now comes the another important thing. Like in big companies, there are thousands of applicants. So what makes it easy for recruiters to notice is that is the referrals. So like in Indian culture and in every companies, like a referral works, okay, but how, let's see how it works. Like suppose, like as I said, suppose Amazon has some opening, I will go to some like people, okay, like my connections, I will ping someone. First of all, I have to take the job ID, like the which job ID I want to apply for. Then you can get from this, just click on the career page and all. Suppose you apply here, you get this job ID from there. So just take the link and all, go to some employer. First, write how you can write is like, you have to write, like first give a little bit introduction about yourself, that you are in like third year or fourth year, then just show that what you have done. Like I say that I'm like 5-star on CodeChef, expert on CodeForces, I have done this internship, or I have been to ACM ICPC. These kinds of things makes an impact on the person that makes him refer you, okay, because not every employee refers everyone. So like if you can write like this, and after writing it, just you post the link that can you refer me for this opening, and also attach your resume along with it, okay. So that's how like a referral. So if the person is like sees your message, and if he thinks that you are good, then he will definitely refer you. Like this is the most important thing, like many people don't do, like they are afraid, like if they fear that why will anyone refer me whom I don't know. Like I have got more referrals from unknown people rather than my own college alumni, okay. So you don't have to be that afraid, like why would anyone refer me whom I don't know. Referrals works like that only. You don't have to worry who you know or not. So just keep DM, like just keep pinging people until you get one referral. That's the thing. You don't have to worry what he will think or not. That's the best advice one of my friend gave me, and it was the best advice till date. Okay. Now, let me tell you, like even without a job ID and all, like suppose some employee of some company posts that there's an opening in my company. Mail your resume, and he gives some mail ID, or he asks to DM him. Then you can just mail him or just send him the connection request. If he accepts, you can just talk with him and ask him to refer. That's a very like good thing that if he can refer you, that will be very so you don't have to always look out for job IDs and all, because big companies what have, they have particular like hiring cycle, like in this month only they hire or some kind of thing. But many other startups, like I've seen many like Quikr, okay, like Bright Money, my experience I'm telling, and many other companies that posts, and even the IIT Delhi internship I got from a professor there, professor who posted that he wanted an research intern who's like and his criteria was the guy should be like above 4-star on CodeShift. That was okay. So that's how I applied. And many different companies like Oyo, Zomato. Zomato, what happened with Zomato, that Zomato don't have their career page. Like they ask, they only rely on employee referrals. Okay. So many other companies are like that, that the like suppose there are some opening in the particular team. So the developers of that team post that, yes, I want some intern or full-time people to join my team. So that's how they mail me my resume, and that's how you contact him, and then you get an opportunity if your resume gets shortlisted. But the problem is you don't get shortlisted most of the time. Like I have applied like about like 10-12 times in Cisco, Intel, JP Morgan and other big companies, but I never got a reply, or I just got a rejection mail. They didn't even allow me to give the online test and all. Most of the companies, like I had referrals in all the companies, like PayPal, Intel, Synopsys, GE Healthcare, Oracle, but these never contacted me for interview, because not always referral help you in getting shortlisted. There are other factors also, like the job description, like if they want some particular skills, or if they require people from who have the particular skills but you don't have, then also then they don't contact you because it's not there in your resume. That is one thing. And many companies, to be honest, many companies don't hire from like our colleges and all these tier 3 colleges. They mostly like call people from NITs and IITs. It's true. Okay. So, and also due to COVID this time, like there was very few openings and all, but now things are changing. And in coming 3-4 years, you will, like there will be ample of opportunities in IT world. Okay. So, and the most like disheartening thing is like, even after giving the online test, like suppose few companies allow you to give online test, like in Microsoft, in from my batch I'm saying, all people who are good at like competitive coding on all give the test, and but no one, only 2 or 3 people got shortlisted, but everyone did this because questions were pretty easy. Everyone did both the question and the MCQs, but not everyone gets the call because there's some particular criteria, or even now I don't know how companies shortlist based on your online rounds, because everyone does the same code, okay, but still not everyone gets a chance to interview. Like in Amazon also, like many people gave the online round, did both the questions, MCQs, but still they didn't get in call for interview. That happens. And you can't say, like every company has different policy. Like suppose 5,000 people give the test, 2,000 people are above the qualifying marks, but they can't interview 2,000 people. So they will select any number of people that they want, and you don't know how they will do it. So it's a mystery. But if you get shortlisted, if after the online round, that means you are lucky. You are really lucky. In companies, like big companies, if you get shortlisted after the online round, that means you are really lucky. So this happens. So, but just keep trying and all, because there are many companies in the market. Even if you, one company don't call you, you can get opportunity at different companies and all. So these are the things that you will notice when you go to like third year or fourth year. but as you are all like pressures and all, but it's better to know, not demotivating, just know that you can prepare well, like right from the hair, like how you can crack online rounds and all. And now I will come to all the preparation and the technical things and important things. Okay, if you have any questions, like, are you getting like things that I'm saying? You can write here in chat box.
Actually, there are a few questions in the chat. If you could check.
Actually, you all can comment your questions in the chat box. I will take those questions. Okay. But let me first, you just keep writing it. I will take when I'm done with this important thing, because okay, let's see, like, this is the most debatable topic everywhere, but very much debatable in KGs, like CP, comparative coding, or development. Okay, what should you do? So let me tell you one thing. Both of them are important. Both can get you good jobs, even at Google or anything. Even if you don't do comparative coding, that's fine. But you need to have good knowledge of data structures and algorithms to crack some companies, good companies, because that's how the interview process are. Like they mainly focus on data structures and algorithms. Most of the big companies, big product-based companies, they mainly, for freshers, they mainly focus on data structure and algorithm, and you can't skip that if you want a job in that. Yeah, it doesn't require much huge knowledge, or you don't need to be a great coder, just need to have your basics clear. So if one does comparative coding, that part becomes a little easier to grasp, like DSA, because they have been doing that from the beginning. So for freshers, I will advise, like, you start exploring, like, you go to CodeShift, CodeForces, at Coder. First, I think if you are new to coding, then first learn some coding language. C++ is the best for comparative coding, and also for interviews also, and Java and Python is also good. Python is very easy to learn. So you can go for the time being. If you are new to coding at all, if you don't know anything about coding, then go to Python. Go for Python. You can get many tutorials on internet. HackerRank, those kinds of platforms help you to learn coding language. Okay. So now let me tell you, like, why competitive coding is important. Competitive programming is important for interviews and all. First of all, the companies don't want competitive programmers. Okay, they want people who are good at data structures and algorithms. But computer programming helps you become good at DSA. So, I have seen many people who don't do competitive coding, but have cracked good companies just by doing lead code, gigs for gigs. Okay, so that's how things works in industry. So, but many companies are there where you can't just mug up standard questions or understand basic things, but there you have to be enough smart or experienced in coding to clear the online rounds and the subsequent rounds. So, like, suppose in Google, DirectAI, Codenation, I don't know if you have heard or not, but this is the company which pays 2 lakh rupees per month. Okay, Codenation, and there are many others also which pays good above 1 lakh and all. So these kind of companies, they want people who are really good at, like, I have seen in Codenation, the most of the employees are all like masters at CodeForces, at least. Okay, masters at CodeForces. So this is very tough to crack. Similarly, DirectAI and few other companies are tough to crack. So that's why I told, like, if you can be good at competitive coding, you have like the chances of cracking those big companies whose interviews are tough. Okay, so just a thing that it will help you. That's how CP is important in interviews and all. Okay, and in online rounds of various companies, you will see that you won't get questions that are very pretty easy, or which are like standard questions which are available in GeekSoGeeks and all. But you will get some good logical questions and all. So doing CP helps building your logical ability. And summary putting is itself is like, it's kind of sport. And if you can enjoy it, you will definitely succeed. But let's talk more about interviews now. You can come tomorrow in Kijan Coders Orientation to know more about competitive coding. Okay, so now, as I was saying, why companies, how you can crack companies without even doing CP, even though I won't suggest. So companies, many companies like Amazon, Microsoft, and all the other companies except these kind of companies, okay, and few others. So these kind of companies just test your DSA skills, data success algorithm, which you can be good at by practicing on Geeks for Geeks, HackerRank, LeetCode. Mostly from second or third year, you should start doing on LeetCode, because it's not much important to start LeetCode from your first year. Because you should try platforms like CodeShift and CodeForces in first year. That I will suggest. So, okay, so most of the companies, what they want is people who are good at data sets. And suppose there are other few topics like trees, linked list, array, and other implementation kind of questions. So people who like solve questions on Geeks for Geeks, LeetCode, and interview bit, these are the platforms that helps you prepare for interviews and all. So here, if you are not much into competitive coding, suppose if you don't like much competitive coding, you can go to these platforms and practice, and that will help you build your logical ability and help you in interviews. So that's why I said most of the companies focus on DSA, and you can be good at it even if you don't have much rating on CodeForces and CodeForces. It depends on how much you can work hard. So apart from big companies, there are many other companies that I was telling that people might not have heard of. Many like unicorns means like $1 billion companies, startups. So which also pay, CTC, I won't tell about CTC, but the base pay, which is enhanced salary, they pay more than 12 LPA, 14 LPA, which is like at par with Amazon, Microsoft, or even more than these companies, okay? So I think you should know about these companies also, which pay good base salary and all. So this is how like CP and all should be your, if you can continue, if you want good product with based companies, then you should start doing competitive coding, or at least start preparing from like basic topics, like stack, queues, arrays, and similar trees, linked lists, those kind of things. Okay, now let me tell you the debatable topic, why should we do development and all. First of all, I was not much into development from first year. I had learned HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and little bit by Django and all, but still I was not much into development. So when I came to third year, but I saw first of all, as I told, many big companies were not interviewing, maybe because of COVID or because of other factors. Many people from management, almost all the big coders and good coders and all, were not getting much interviews at good companies. So what I did was I started applying for startups and other good companies and all. So what happens in few startups, they give task-based assignment, because what happens in startups, they are fast-paced. Fast-paced means they work really fast. And big companies like Microsoft, Google, these are slow-paced. You can work at your own pace, learn and contribute. But in startups, you have to add value to the company along with learning. So they want people who are already good at their tech stack that they are using. So they give you this task-based assignments. So just a second, let me drink water. Yeah, so as I was saying, what happens here is so they give you some assignment, they give you to make some backend project where you have to use suppose Node or any backend framework, and also some front-end framework and things which are required to build some application. So if you are, or if you already know those things, then it will be very easy for you to make those tasks and all. But if you don't know, then it will be difficult, because they give hardly max 1 week 10. So if you can learn those tech stack, then it's okay. But it's very difficult for a non-development person to crack those tasks and all. So that's why development is also necessary, not compulsory, but it helps. Okay, like in CodeShift and CodeShift, I couldn't did it because I didn't know that PHP and React and all. So I couldn't get that internship because I didn't have much experience in that. And in other different startups also, they give you task-based assignments. So, but later I started learning Django, and I got internship at Bright Money. And then in BrowserStack also, there was one, there are a few development questions also in face to face also. So that development also helped me in getting an internship. So, and the most, suppose if you are a competitive coder, you don't have much development experience, what you can do is you learn few tech stack, be it Node.js or Django, and make some projects. Because as I said in this resume making, you have to add projects also to get your CV noticed. Okay. So if you have some good projects, that's very beneficial for you. But it completely depends on you. Like, many people don't like development, many don't like competitive coding. So I will suggest, let's explore both these. I have a diverse background. Like, I've tried competitive coding, data science, development also. Liked few things, didn't like few things. So things happen, and whatever experiences I have, that have always helped. So learning never goes wasted. So if you get time, try development also, and make at least one or two good projects. That will help you in interviews also. What happens, suppose after clearing the online round, there are at least two technical rounds. So in most company, what companies do is, in first round, they will give you two DSA question, data structure and algorithm question, which you have to solve in 45 minutes. Okay. So if you can solve those, that's fine. In next round, what happens again, they can give you a DSA question and they can ask you about your projects. Okay. So they are, if you can't justify your project, don't just copy paste some project. That will backfire. So if you are putting some projects on your resume, make sure that you know about the project. Even if you have copied, just make sure that you know everything about the project. Okay. So that's how projects can help, because in most of the interviews, they will ask you about your projects. Even in Microsoft interview or Amazon interviews also, what they did in last round, suppose they give one coding question to people, and then they asked, they started asking questions from your projects, what is this project, how you have done it, and all. So both of these are important, depends on your interests and abilities, that how you are able to do this. It's completely fine that if you don't like, suppose if you don't like CP, go for start practicing on Geeks for Geeks LeetCode. That's fine. If you don't like development, go for CP. And even if you don't like both, then also you can be good at DSA and all by practicing in these platforms. And how to manage CP and Dev, I told you, totally depends on your interest. Like, if you can give time to both, it's pretty good. If not, then it's also okay, but have some knowledge about everything. It's good. Now, let me tell you, interview, like the interview thing and all, like, that is important. Like, suppose you get them online, if you clear online round, then what you will do? You have to prepare for face-to-face interviews. So I got rejected in few face-to-face interviews. I cracked also few face-to-face interviews. So I learned many things, that what should we do and what we should not do. Like, suppose some question is given, algorithm question is given. So you have to first tell your approach to the interviewer and not just start coding like you do in competitive coding. You just open your editor and write code. So that's not how interview works. You have to first tell your approach. Make sure the interviewer understands. The communication is a very important thing. Okay, I have seen my seniors getting rejected because of this. And in HR round also, very people get rejected because they are not able to impress the HR and all, because they lack communication skills. So apart from coding, you have to make your interviewer understand what you are thinking, how you will solve the question. That's the most important thing than doing question. So that's what I learned. Like, even if you can't complete a question, if the interview gets that, yeah, you are on the right track, you are thinking right, logic is correct, then also it is, it helps that the interviewer will think, yeah, he's good. Maybe because it doesn't have much experience in coding and all, like writing data structures, but his logic is good. So that also helps. So make sure that your communication skills are very are good. It helps. So I think I should take questions now, because you should have many questions. So okay, format email, okay. Wow, many questions. How to start CP from scratch? Go to HackerRank or CodeSurf and CodeForces. Go to any one platform. Just go to the beginner section. Okay, let me show you. My screen is presenting now. Yeah. Let's go to CodeForces. Like in 14 Jan, there is one contest, and go to previous contest. Like, go to any contests and just see previous contests. Just see that if you are able to do the first question or not. That's how you start. It's nothing like you have to do some course before starting. You just start, okay? And even while solving questions, you will notice that, yeah, this question requires string algorithm, or it requires segment tree or similar thing. So you will then search on the net, and the most. But so that's how you learn. And the most important, the best thing to learn CP is like participate in CodeSurf long challenges. CodeSurf long challenges are made to learn only, because you will get 10 days, you will get 8 or 10 questions. So you have to think, you will get ample amount of time to search, like how you will do solve this problem. So that's how you start learning. So if you already know some programming language like C++, Java or Python, then just start doing CodeSurf long challenges. And don't think about rating. Like in first year, I also thought much about rating and all. I reduced practicing later on, but that's a bad thing. So when you are newbie, don't think about rating. just practice. Later on, if you think that yeah, you are good and your writing is good, then you can participate in selected contests. But if you are a beginner, just go to any competitive coding sites and just practice, and you will start learning. And you will just automatically you will see that I don't know this topic, and you will search on internet. So that Google is the most important, like, most helpful thing where you can learn competitive coding. There are many resources also, like CodeChef. CCDSAP, this is a very good thing. What they have removed and what? CodeChef certification. Yeah, so this is one thing, that CodeChef certification. And here you can get a roadmap of competitive coding. So you can just go to prepare, go to foundation, and you can see the syllabus, and you can also get learning resources along with the questions. So this is, I think, the best roadmap one can start. So this is the two things that I would like to say. Just start doing, and while doing, you will automatically come to know where to find things. Okay, so please tell about competitive coding. What is this? I already said, like, competitive coding is just support that helps you develop your logical thinking ability. And if you are good at coding, you can get many achievements and all that will look good on your resume. Okay, and it has many other perks also, like. If you participate in coding courses in college fairs, you will get money also in very different. Like I have also won many. I've got money from with participating fests of different colleges in my college also, and few contests on CodeChef also, which are like regional contests, not world level. But that's how it helps. So you should start competitive coding. Like as I already said, start long challenge. And you will come to know that what are the things you should know. And if you need help, then you start pinging your second seniors and all. Okay. From which year? Start from first year if you are okay. If not, I've seen people who started from second year and are now 5-star, 6-star. So it doesn't matter. But if you can start early, it's good. I'm able to solve 4 questions. Actually, any question? Start like doing more questions. This also happened with me, like I was not able to solve more questions and all. So what you need to do is you should start practicing questions which are above your level. Okay, so this code forces help, because while you go to like problem sets, you can sort the problems based on difficulty, and there are many other. So this is how like difficulty questions are like sorted. Like suppose if you know that I am not being able to do much questions on DP or segmentary, so you should start doing. If you will get stuck, you will feel frustrated also, but it takes time. So don't get demotivated because you are not able to do more than 4 questions and all. You have to just keep practicing. And you will see the results if you practice like honestly. Then if not in 1 month, 2 months, then in 5 months or 6 months, you will definitely see growth. So just evaluate yourself, like in which topic you are weak and all. So that's how it works. Is it easy to study in CSIT if not how to do some code branches? Being in KGC is itself a bad thing, and being from a non-CSCIT is even more problematic if you are in KGC, but it doesn't stop you from getting what you want. There are many people from non-CSC branches which are doing well in IT industry. So it's the same thing. But you don't have to worry about because in campus you won't see companies that doesn't allow mechanical student, because you companies won't visit, so you don't have to worry about it. All you have to worry about is off-campus opportunities. So in off-campus, few companies, obviously bar only CSIT people, but in many startups or many different, like Google or many other Google or Microsoft or few good companies, like they don't have any problem with the branch, okay, and even with CGP. So these companies are your targets, or even startups, like all these big startups, even be it Zomato, Swiggy, Flipkart. Flipkart won't hire from us, it's no problem. But many other companies, which they allow mechanical, electrical branches. So just if you have to, you might face problems because you are from core branches, you won't get much time. But if you are able to solve problem and give time to coding, then I think it won't be of much problem, because in off campus everyone is similar. So that's how all the things that I've already told how to apply and all. So just make sure you apply to companies which don't have any problem with mech branches. So other than that, you are not at any disadvantage. Everything is same for you. Your learning and all, everything depends on you. Being in KGC, being in CSE or IT, it doesn't matter, because I have also learned almost zero thing about coding from my in college. Mechanical have also learned almost zero thing in college. There are a few, I won't say the teachers were not good, few teachers were good, few subjects were also good, but you won't learn about algorithms and all in college. Okay, so that thing. Soft skills are also important. Like soft skills are like in coding, giving solution to interviewer, that how you approach the problem, that if you can't communicate, if he is not able to get your idea, then we will not be impressed. So that is, soft skills are also important. If you can't speak English, or you like can't communicate properly, so both are important, but obviously coding is more important, but soft skills are crucial. It can get you rejected, okay? So that's how things, like in HR interview, like I don't know if you know or not, Sarthak Da, our like senior, he's in DSHA now, but he also got rejected in HR round of Microsoft. He cleared all the technical rounds, but he got rejected in HR, and other companies also, he faced many rejections. So this happens. Soft skills are also important. What point should we able to write a formal email? Okay, let me show you. I shouldn't. But suppose this is how you write a thing while applying. This, what you have done, this, and what you have done, this. Internships, and you are a good coder and all, then just say I want to apply, and give all the details, DOB or branch, these are the things, and attach your resume. That's enough. If he likes your profile, she likes your profile, he will contact you. Don't have to think about that. It's not in your hand. Is it necessary to study in CSIT? If not, then how? Already covered, no? I know basic programming. I also knew only basic programming till 12. So as I told, go to CodeChef, follow this roadmap if possible, or just go to CodeChef HackerDank, solve beginner level problems first, then move on to medium or tough question, tough levels. So participating contests first, because contests give you the questions, and you yourself might not get to know like what questions should I prepare. So contests are like very good thing to practice. That's how it works. Which books or sites? I have already told, HackerDank, HackerEarth, CodeChef, CodeForces. Books, I don't follow books. Okay, But if you want, like Geeks for Geeks is a very important, like everything that can be on book that should be needed are covered in Geeks for Geeks. Almost every topic is there in Geeks for Geeks. That's how it. Also, there is one website CP. CPalgorithms.com. Here you can read about the theories of all the algorithms, data structure theory of all the. There are questions also. So this is one also important thing if you don't want to follow book. Which is better, Android? See, Android. Like in job opportunities in Android are completely different from Wave and all. Like what in software development is not web development or Android development. Okay, it's all about the all applications and all. It can be anything. The software developer does all the tasks from testing to building architectures. So if you have a good laptop of 8 GB RAM and all, and first year I didn't have. So I didn't do much Android and all, and it was also not much of my interest. So but I did web development, basic web development. So just see if you have a good laptop and if that interests. If you know Java, that will be very good to start with Android. But if not, just go for web development. Most of major, all the companies prefer web developer and all, like in task based questions and all. So you will get an ample amount of opportunities with web development. Can I work on HackerRank? Work or practice? Okay, so HackerRank is good, but it doesn't does contests nowadays. It has stopped doing like giving preparing contests. So just go to practice section of HackerRank, then it will help. Whatever. So HackerRank has good good for beginners. Like yeah, the problems are sorted according to categories wise. That login. But I for competitive coding. I will suggest for contests, go to CodeChef. That's the best. For long challenges are the best to practice. And then you can just start from problem solving. Here you can. All the topics are sorted according to the categories. Okay, taking time. Okay, so this is both are good. Contest, go to CodeChef to learn basics and I'll go to Hacker. So the beginner follow Geeks for Geeks. This beginner should follow to learn, follow Geeks for Geeks and all, and to practice, go to Code Forces. Practice beginner questions first. If you try the hard questions, you will get frustrated. So what do you mean by good projects? Good projects are that which are not like making it a tic-tac-toe game or just a simple calculator app. Okay, so these kinds of projects are very like common projects and all. Anyone can get this project. They are very simple to do, and you can easily, it is easily available on GitHub or any platform. So for good projects, I mean which has a good UI or at least a good backend. Okay, so that's how you good projects should be there. If it's something unique, it's good. But if it's not, suppose you make a library management system or you make some Android app, which crops the pictures and any kinds of Android app and all, where you have done something which are useful, okay, and which are not very common, like. Not everyone can get in, like they will know, Lena, that this is a very common thing and you can easily get so you might have copied it. So that's how they differentiate between good and bad projects. So that would do something which is not easily available. Okay. Let's work on embedded systems. So this is more simple. If you want to work on embedded systems, you don't need to this to do this CP and all, because you want job in core EC sector. So I think you should first search on it, how to follow this and what. But coding is requiring that also. So if you can practice basic coding of this person, that's enough. But for embedded system, I don't have much idea. So ask some EC senior. Let me give you all the links. I have done some projects on Python and LinkedIn and YouTube. Are they helping me? Depends what kind of it will help, obviously, but like interview will ask you, what is this project? What have you done in this? So it will help, but upload in LinkedIn, like make sure that you have added the GitHub link or the live project link in your resume also, so they can easily see, go and check that what you have done. And if they ask, it will help, obviously, but it's not that you have just made simple Python game and all. But if it's okay, it's okay, whatever project you have done, just make sure you know about that project. Game development. Game development requires enough practice experience. Okay, so it's a different thing. Like you have to be good. You have to. It's not that the company will give you a job, then you will learn game development. You have to first learn yourself, make good projects, and then showcase on LinkedIn or on your resume and all. Then you can get opportunities. There are many game development countries, like startups in India also. And there are a few big game development companies like Jenga, if you have heard of. So you can try in those companies. And but that requires a good level of projects and experience. It's a tough, I think. So that's something to get. Where do you get the motivations of projects? Projects motivation. I see. Whatever projects I have are mostly during my internships that I have done, and also a few others that I have done on my own. So my motivation comes from the experiences. The people tell me to do for their company. So this is one thing. But you should do projects. I think there are many articles on, suppose, Medium. Every time you make a blue app, a cat dies. So puppy dies. Okay. So there are many articles, like different kinds of projects, like what you should. So you will get an idea from here, like many different kinds of what kind of projects should you make. There are which are not like very common, and also from here you can get the motivation, what kind of projects should we make. Or also you can just go to any LinkedIn profile, okay, and stalk him or her, see that resume, see what this guy has done in his college, what projects he has done. So here you can get an idea how to be projects. Product-based companies prefer development. Product-based companies prefer DSA. Okay, but if you know, if you have projects and internships, that will help in your interviews. Having clone project is good for resume. Clone projects, if you copy, it's not good. That you should know about the project. Apply for right time for applying for internships is that whenever you have good projects and all, the major companies won't like give you a chance before the third year, because all the product based companies, what they do is they give 2 months internship, summer internship, and you get a PPO after that, or 6 months internship, that is in final year, and after that you get a PPO. So from second year also you can apply in different startups and all. Just go to LinkedIn jobs and all, you will find many internships and also. That's how, just keep applying that from second year or third year. Very good. So obviously after first year, but before third year, these are the important and crucial times to apply for internships. Is love, yes, love Baba, 450 questions are good, but if you practice honestly, then it's good. Projects on Python, just search on Google, you will definitely get many projects. Most preferable language. Preferable language in interviews are like C++ and Java, because you like companies, you should not do interview problems in front of interviewer in Python, because it's a very straightforward language, very inbuilt features. So it's not preferred, but C++, and you should know at least C++ or Java. So these are the programming language. Ajah, get familiar with GitHub. There is not much open source culture in our college, but DSC is like doing a good job of to like development and all. So I think go to any search about GSOC. There are many organizations which have already gone to GSOC. So from there you can get a list of organizations which have like which are very established in open source and all. So first of all, you know about Git and GitHub. Okay, get your hands on some like technology, be it any Java, HTML, CSS, React, Node, whatever, and find organizations which work on those technologies, and just go to the issues section. So this is one open source organization. Okay, you choose one repo. You have to join the, I think there are channels where you can talk with this mailing list or chat channel to get in touch with the developers. So you should join this first. You go to the issues. Okay, choose beginner level issues. You can see the level from here. Good first issue or something. Yes. There are no good first. Okay. So any good first issues and all, just see that if you can solve this that issue. Okay. Go and comment like how you will do that. If the developer says okay, then he will assign you. Then you have to do this. So this is how open source works. And like in for GSOC, you can search on it like how you should, if you are a regular contributor of an organization, then you have very good chance to get GSOC with that organization. You can search more about GSOC. Search Google. Google. Okay. Yeah, language I have to. So any more questions you have? Okay, so yeah, the experiences, like told, see the like the main motive of this like webinar was to tell you that there are many opportunities off campus which many people don't know. My batchmates have also struggled a lot. I have also struggled a lot to first to get opportunity, then to get interview, and then to crack those. So just keep applying, keep figuring out where you are lacking. If you're lacking in DSA, practice those. If you're lacking in communication, or you don't have, if you don't have good projects, just keep improving yourself, and eventually you will get a good opportunity for sure. And there are many, like my seniors, like Sarthak Da has faced many questions. I have also faced my very people, like even before applying, we even before giving a test, we fail rejections. Many a times it happens. So that's perfectly fine. You just need one good product-based company. So even if many companies rejects you, that doesn't matter. It happens. But if you are good enough, you will definitely get a good opportunity. So just start practicing on platforms, or start doing like coding and development. It will help. Just follow a roadmap. Keep practicing, and things will follow. If you are good enough, good thing will happen to you. Just that's the thing.
Placements, research based internships.
Like I said, like for research based internship, contact any professor of some NIT or IIT. Contact on either LinkedIn, or if you have some contact, if talked with some senior, if they have done some internships at like NIT or IIT, so they can give you the mailing list. What I got from like in LinkedIn only, one professor said, okay, opportunity. So I applied from there. You have to contact professor or PhD scholar. Placement scenario is mostly service-based companies come. TCS, CTS, Wipro, and few other startups also come. Now in this year, or I think few companies have come, but all pays around this 5-6 max. Like TCS Digital pays 7 LP, and that's the like highest you can get on campus. I mean on campus, and others mostly 3-4 discounts. But off campus you have to. That's why I'm doing this seminar, because I thought this is very important thing. Like if you know how to apply and crack off campus, it will be very, very beneficial if you are from KGS. Experiences, internships, like it's internships are just like a job. You have to keep learning while adding value to the company. You have to be discipline, not it's not like some college projects and all. So you, if you do one, you will automatically get to know. It's not much. Every company has different work environment and all.
It's okay to do CP algo, no dev, and only 1-2 or 2 good projects. If you are aiming in big product based companies, it's okay if you don't know much development, or some projects in your resume will work.
Did I miss any good question? ML jobs right after college? The ML jobs don't have, like for beginners, you don't have much opportunity in ML field. Like many good people, like Animesh Da and from my batch Sujan. So what happens is mostly you get only small startups and all, because there are not much opportunities for freshers. They prefer skilled and experienced people, and opportunities are also less. So in ML you have to be consistent, you have to be patient. Like maybe in 1-2 years after your graduation, you will definitely land a good job, but initially you have to be patient for ML jobs.
Some tips for people who started.
Just keep practicing. There is nothing as tips. Whenever you get stuck, Google. That's your friend.
Is it all? Okay. Research-based internships and in like in IT sector, in corporate world, you will get to learn more than a research-based internship. Like practical experience will be much more. In research-based, you will more learn about specific projects and all. That's also good. That's slow-paced.
there is nothing as such that you have some targets or deadline to finish, but in corporate you have. So if you want to do higher studies, having a research internship is good. If you want to be in corporate world, have good job after graduation, you should do corporate internships in companies. Offline editor, VS Code, Sublime, Get with CP. You might have heard of Abhijit Agarwal. He's in Google now, interacted last year. So he also used to do coaching for Gate, but he is all very smart. So he used to practice on CodeSwift mainly. And so he managed both competitive coding and Gate. And well, in third year, fourth year, so he practiced a lot on coding platform. So he cracked Google, so he left Gate. So just you have to manage time. First, you have to like make your priority, like what you have want to do. If you want to get a job, just make sure, keep it in mind that you want it. Just don't get distracted. Obviously, I know like it gets very difficult to get a good job from our college, but the people are getting if they are good enough. But if you want to do MTech, just make sure that, yeah, okay, I will do Gate preparation and all. It depends on your interests and priority. And this time management is also required. You won't have much study pressure in our college, but for Gate and CP, you have to manage time. I've already told people have done it, so you can also do. Yeah, Atom is also good. Okay. Anything else? I should tell more. Just keep asking if you have any doubt in any thing that I said, or if you are not able to get what I mean, you can ask that. If not, Mayuk can take over.
Okay. Are there any more doubts? Okay, I don't think there
are. If I missed something, you can retype this or retype your question if I have missed answering your question.
Yeah. If anyone whose question has not been answered, you can type it up once more.
Okay, I have. Questions have been answered. I hope you have got an idea where to start, how to prepare, and what are different opportunities, all the good things and bad things about job and all. So just make sure whatever you do, just keep doing.
Okay, Pravajda, I think there is one last question. It's from Sudeep Maiti. He's asking, at what year should I apply for internship, and how will I be able to get to know that if my coding skills are good enough to get an internship at that time?
As I told, like for good product-based companies, they usually hire at the end of third year. So interviews are mostly like in your fifth sem, okay, fifth or sixth sem. So before that, if you want to get internship in startups, make sure you are good at development. So that's important. But for in good product-based companies, if you can see that, yes, you have practiced. In lead code, suppose you have practiced almost 100 questions, okay, then be sure that you are good. And if in competitive coding, if you are doing competitive coding from 1 or 2 years, then yeah, you are good to go. Maybe you will get rejection even after all this, but just keep giving interviews. So giving an interviews will let you know that where you are lacking. So also try to give mock interviews with friends if you are in third year or fourth year. That will help. Time I have set, just keep practicing. And just don't self-reject yourself that, can I be able to crack this company? And just keep give interview, then you will definitely get to know. Pool campusing, like many companies, a company chooses a region, okay? Like almost 15-20 colleges they choose, and they allow everyone who applied from those colleges to give the tests and interviews. And off campus is that company like post opening, and like people apply there. And if like, there are many people apply, it's not restricted to a particular college and or what or something. So you have to get, as I told, like referrals or resume, these are important things. So in pool campus, it becomes easier. In on campus, it's become even more easier. In off campus, it's a bit tough. That's how things. Okay, so this is the basic difference. Why these questions are not asked? Why you want to join the company? These are typical. These are asked by TCS, CTS, and not by good product. I have given many interviews in many good product based also startups also. I have not been asked this question, why you want to join the company. Okay, they will ask some question like a challenge question like what you have done, like will you be able to give enough time to this company. And in TCS interviews, they ask what are your strong points, what are your weakness strengths. But mostly companies don't ask these repetitive questions nowadays. Interstellar is good, but only if you want stipends around 3 to 4K or 5K, then it's good. But ultimately, it's not a good product nowadays. So if you are in first or second year, Internshala is best if you want to apply for, if you want to get started with internships. Like I got my first internship from Internshala. Stipend was very low, but I got that in third semester. So at least I have one at that time. So I just did one. So Internshala is good only at the beginning level, but you won't get good opportunities in Internshala. Very unknown companies, fraud companies are also there. So it's good in the beginning. Yeah, try AngelList, try LinkedIn jobs. These are good. AngelList is good. But all these Internshala, AngelList, mostly you will get startups. So as I told, like there are many others for good startups like Razorpay, Udaan, Oyo, Dunjo, BrowserStack, which pay good salary and all. And very good. These are the growing startups. So if at par with Fang or product-based companies, or if not, then also very unknown startups at least pay 6 to 8 or 10 LPM. So it's good. Startups are also good to learn. Okay. I hope you got many insights today. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So I'd like to thank Pravasda for this wonderful session. I hope each and everyone got an insight, as Dada said. I'd like to thank him for answering each and every question meticulously. Thank you so much for this wonderful session. And yeah, if you have doubts, you can later on also, you can ask us, your immediate second years or anyone. Okay.
You
can also contact Dada. Yeah, Facebook or LinkedIn, whatever.
You can also contact me, people from my batch or your immediate second or third year. Because all are good. It's not that I'm doing this session. So only I have achieved. No, many people from my batch has achieved and are good at competitive coding and other things, are good at development also. You can approach anyone. Anyone from KGC will help you.
Okay. So yeah, before we sign off for the day, I'd just like to address one last matter. We are like every year we are forming a WhatsApp group for each and everyone who are interested in development. Okay, your immediate seniors will be there, and some lead and co-members of our DSC group will be there. Over there you can ask us your doubts regarding development or anything. Okay, so we'll be rolling out the joining link. Okay, and you guys need to join. Okay, means if it's your wish, you can join. Okay. So for that, I'd like,